So what are we going to talk about today? I met two types of people on the road. Those who are obsessed with politics and those who hate politics. They have one thing in common, which is like they actually don't want to talk to each other. I have so many friends and family in general that when you say politics, they won't talk. When you say, oh, like, did you hear what happened to this person? They will not say, unless it's a divorce or something, you know, a little bit more specific. But people who actually hate the word politics, especially my friends, it's not that they hate politics, and it's not that they don't have opinions, because they do have opinions. I mean, everybody has opinions about everything, obviously. Think of COVID, right? All my friends are very vocal on the political side of things. They just don't say it as a political fact. But the majority of my friends are worried of where am I going to be able to have a job tomorrow? Can my kids go to school? Can I visit grandma? How will be the situation with the lockdown in the future? So it's not a problem of opinion, but it's more of a problem of they don't feel listened. They feel that whatever they say, nobody's gonna listen. And I guess that on that note, you know, I guess that the only ones to blame are us, the ones who kind of work on the field of politics, because many times we actually like to talk and many of us have very strong opinions. But many of us actually fail a little bit to listen. The good news is that people are starting to realize that they are the only ones who can change their own situations and their own problems. They are the only ones who can solve them, especially with younger generations. I mean, you see it when these people join movement like the Green Movement and these protests on Fridays. Do you see how actually the people understand that politics is one of the vehicles, but it's not the only vehicle? And also the good news is that, you know, people like me or the people who I work with, we can change and we can learn to actually engage. We can learn that being in politics doesn't mean just to be the loudest one in the room, which is a challenge of mine, but you can also go to the communities and then you can start listening. Because at the end of the day, politics is actually not only about representation. Representation is a privilege, and you're not there just because you're smarter. You're there because you're empowering the community. You're there because you're supposed to listen, and then you are supposed to actually understand what the problems are. And in the road, I can tell you that my most gratifying experience has been to meet people who, yes, sometimes they make comments that you go like, ugh. But on the positive side, then you start understanding what was it on the first place that helped them create that comment that made you roll your eyes. And if you actually work in politics, and I'm talking to you, if you actually you work in politics, you work in social movements, if you work with the public good and you're not able to understand where people come from, what are their backgrounds, what are their fears, and why are they making the comments, if your job is only to roll the eyes, and not to actually listen and understand them, then this is the wrong game for you. Because at the end of the day, actually, it's all about engagement. And people hate politics just because they are not being listened. So what about if we start listening and then everybody understands that this is just a day-to-day thing?